How's it going, everyone? If you have not seen the first part of this video, check out the annotation or click the link in the description. This is part 2 of my Becoming Fire Punch video, where I made a build around the Demon Fist in Dark Souls 3. In this video, I will be finishing up the two DLCs of the game using only the Demon Fist. I'm at the point in levels where the fist cannot gain any more damage unless I put 2 levels into the stat, so this is going to be very interesting. Ah, yes. The Painted World. Let's hope my flaming fist can keep me warm here. Yeah, I'll shut up. I push forward through the fellas, only for the earth to crumble under my sheer weight. Then I find some dogs. And injure the big boy. I make my way past the towers, only for the earth to crumble once again. I go and snag the bonfire. And of course, I get invaded on the legendary bridge spot. But the guy was honorable, and it was a pretty good fight, so GG's. I make my way up to the church across the bridge and talk to the sexy-voiced man.
Well, well. Your Lady Yuri is Lord of Hollows.
Then I go and talk to some suspicious-looking nun.
Welcome to the painted world of Ariandel.
I stop to hear Wilhelm's voice one more time.
She has spoken, has she not? Then tarry no longer and be gone. Carry on. For Lady Yuri.
God, he's so cool. It is now time to break the bridge.
Oh, okay.
And venture down the branches. I swear I made it down here first try. I mean, trust me, it was my first try. And light the bonfire. I accidentally piss off the ice crabs. And now it's time for the easiest boss of the DLC. Gravetender and his dog. I was actually able to beat these fellas first try. They really don't have that much health. It's easy enough to stunlock Gravetender since he's a human, with the Demon Fist spin. His big boy is also easy to wail on when he just stands still. Thanks to Pontiff's Eye Ring, he takes a beating. If only other bosses were this easy.
First try.
Anyway, I continue forth, taking the best slide in the game, where I get invaded by someone with a very interesting name. Like, what the fuck, man? Why did you name your character that? I find the guy wearing lapse armor, so I just assume the dude's gonna be an asshole. But then he decides to drop me 100 embers? So, thanks, I guess, man? I don't approve the name, but thanks. I continue forth, climbing on the rooftops. I hop on down, and I find Gale's armor. That bastard. I make my way over and open the gate to the town. Why is this shit so slow? This is 3x speed. The time has come. I must kill the sexy-voiced man.
I've seen your kind, time and time again. Every fleeing man must be caught. Every secret must be unearthed. Such is the conceit of the self-proclaimed seeker of truth. But in the end, you lack the stomach for the agony that you'll bring upon yourself.
I need to hear this man recite a 5,000-page book. Still, it's so sad. I open the door, then talk to the girl.
'Tis good.
I go and grab the bonfire. I make my way through the forest and head over to the tree to kick it down for the shortcut. Wait, didn't I just... Did you guys know that if you hold a torch, it actually stops the maggots from inflicting bleed? The more you know. I swat away some flies. And now it's time for the main event of DLC 1. Sister Freed is an interesting boss. When I first played this game, I swore she was the hardest boss in the entire game, and I still think that she's in the top 3 due to her 3 phases. Phase 1 is easy enough, just backstab Fisher on repeat. Phase 2, just focus Father, because boy, he can take a beating. Just don't get hit by Freed. Then you have to deal with Phase 3, on hopefully enough healing flask. When I say this fight was very annoying,
no! Please don't kill. Oh, okay. No, what?
She can't do that! No!
The fight was very annoying. Luckily, she's a bit weak to fire, so I did do good damage to her. Unlike some other bosses, DLC 2, after about 8 attempts, I was finally able to take her down. Now it's time for DLC 2! This DLC features two, count 'em, two bosses who are resistant to fire.
Yippee!
Yippee!
I begin the DLC by falling. Then I run past some knights. Go and kill the most annoying enemy in the game. God, I hate these fuckers. Then I promptly get shit on.
That hit, dude. No. No, I was not near it. No, no.
Why didn't you heal, you moron? I find a suspicious fellow.
Oh, look at you. You've got your head screwed on, correct?
Then I must continue on and dodge all these stupid-ass lasers from this annoying enemy. Like, at least once you kill them, they don't come back, but man, they still suck. I continue through the poison swamp, dodging all the lasers I possibly can. Then I run into a real roadblock that my ego won't let me just run past. The Desert Pyromancer. This was one of the harder fights in the DLC because good fucking lord is it hard to get within punching range of her. And when I did get within punching range of her, I did not do a lot of damage since all I have is a fire weapon.
No! What? Oh!
After many tries, I was finally able to kill her. Oh, please, never again. Never again. Well, too bad, because here's another fire enemy, and this time, it's a boss. The dual demons are a hassle to deal with in any run, but when your weapon does fire damage and they're resistant to fire, thank you Miyazaki that they're not immune to fire, it makes it a bit more challenging. The first phase is not terrible, but man, the second phase is pretty annoying due to the amount of jumping around that the Demon Prince does. Also, one punch from my fist did a whopping 180 damage, but as long as I took the fight slow, I was able to beat it.
Yeah!
We have made it to the last section of the game. The Ringed City! I make my way past the giant boy. Have a run-in with the local.
Many of these are by the fire, forsaken.
Then I go and say hello to the Ring Knight. And then I booked my way to the next bonfire. There's just too many deadly enemies over here. I swear, I don't know why they decided to put so many over here. I then make my way around the building and go unlock the door on the other side of the bonfire. Now it's time to make it past Midir. So I go and get cooked by Midir. Actually make my way through his fire and end up at the spiral staircase and struggle to remember how to get out of this place. And finally make it to the bonfire. I challenge Midir on the bridge. After taking my time, I was finally able to fist Midir, sending him down to the pit below. I make my way forward and unlock the shortcut back to the bonfire. Now it's time to fight Half-Light. The fight is simple enough. Go in, kill Argo. He's a very big pushover. The first time I fought Half-Light, I actually was able to get the AI instead of a player. I wasn't even playing offline. Doesn't matter though, because the AI still kicked my ass in the end. Next attempt is back to a real player. It was a pretty close fight, but I couldn't clutch up the win.
That didn't even hit me.
What the fuck is a hitbox? Third try's the charm, so I tried to spin the win, and it actually worked on Darth Jar Jar. Thank you, Darth Jar Jar, because I hate this boss. I go back and grab the +3 stamina ring by dropping on Gwyn's pointy head. Now this bad boy will help out a lot. I then make the trek down to Midir. I love doing the plunging attack down this hole. It makes you feel very epic. But now, it's time for Midir. People will tell you that Midir is the hardest boss in the game, and with some builds, he is definitely the hardest, but he has two attacks that are very easy to damage him with, and then you just dodge the rest, and try not to get greedy. His damn laser attack is always so hard to dodge, like, goddamn it, stupid hitbox doesn't make any sense. If I am able to land a two-hit attack, I can do almost 400 damage to Midir, which is not too shabby. This is the run that I was able to get him down really low on. Too bad I ran out of healing. After about an hour of attempts later, I was finally able to get the timing down and whittle his health down all the way. Rest in peace, Midir. Now on to the most difficult boss of this build.
Gale.
I do not do a lot of damage. Now Gale is a different story. Two punches only does about 300 damage to him. This doesn't really make sense to me because Gale is technically weak to strike and not resistant to fire, unlike Midir, who's resistant to fire, so I don't know why it's like this, but I guess I have to deal with it. Gale attacks so fast that there's not really a point for me to have on the Pontiff rings, so I switched out the healing one for Lloyd's ring to get that extra damage when I'm at full health. That really seemed to make a difference. Phase 3 Gale is always a different beast, but dodging his lightning and attacks led me to be able to take him down with the help of an ember. Rip guts. I mean Gale. And don't worry, I went and killed Shira. And gave the girl the Dark Soul. Thank you for watching this video. It has been a long time coming. I would definitely be down to make some more Dark Souls videos in the future. I still have not played through Dark Souls 2, or I could do another build similar to this kind of structure of video. I have a few ideas for some characters that I can become in the game, such as maybe doing an Ishigo build, but leave a comment if you have any characters that you would like to see me build in Dark Souls. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video and want to see some more stuff like this in the future. Thanks for watching.
Eleanor, help me.